Now theorem 8, every element A in a Boolean algebra has a unique inverse, that is A inverse. Now for proving this one, let's suppose something, okay, or let's assume it. Now let's assume that A1 inverse and A2 inverse are both inverse of A. So we have supposed A1 inverse and A2 inverse are the both inverse for A. Now, by definition of inverse, or you can also write it complement, okay. So by definition what we can write it, we can write it A plus A1 inverse is equal to 1, A dot A1 inverse is equal to 0, and A plus A2 inverse is equal to 1, and A dot A2 inverse is equal to 0. One single property applying for two inverses, okay. So now what we have to prove, basic thing is we have to prove that A1 inverse is equal to A2 inverse, okay. So now let's start with proof. Now A1 inverse, we can write it A1 inverse as A1 inverse dot 1 by identity. First thing, okay. Then A1 inverse can be written as A1 inverse in the bracket A plus A2 inverse, okay. To 1 we can write this one, A plus A2 inverse. Now what this is? By inverse. Now this becomes A1 inverse dot A plus A1 inverse dot A2 inverse. By distributive. Now this becomes 0 plus A1 inverse dot A2 inverse. Now this becomes hypothesis. To this even we can write it now A with A2 inverse plus A1 inverse dot A2 inverse. Okay, now here what we are having for this part, we are having A1 inverse dot A is equal to A dot A2 inverse is equal to 0. This is what? Because A1 and A2 both are the inverse of A. Okay. Now further. Now this becomes A plus A1 inverse dot A2 inverse. Distributive law. Now remember one thing, when you are opening this part, you will be having A2 dot A2, that is A2 single times, okay. A dot A is A. Now this becomes 1 dot A2, again inverse. And this is A2 by identity. Now what we have proved, just check it, what we have done it, we have shown that A1 inverse is equal to A2 inverse, okay. So So therefore A1 inverse is equal to A2 inverse, we have proved this thing. Okay, now what we can write it? Hence the two inverses is identical therefore inverses unique.